on to the holy sacrifice of the Mass. Today's Mass is being offered for Tessa Zabel. The Lord said, I think about the peace, and not the living.
You will call upon me, and I will answer you,
and I will bring back your happiness from a very place.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your Word made flesh and splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for this full and lasting happiness, to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a scroll in the right hand of the one who sat on the throne. It had writing on both sides and was sealed with seven seals. Then I saw a mighty angel who proclaimed in a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the scroll and break its seals?" But no one in heaven or on earth or under the earth was able to open the scroll or to examine it. I shed many tears because no one was found worthy to open the scroll or to examine it. One of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. The Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has triumphed, enabling him to open the scroll with its seven seals." Then I saw standing in the midst of the throne and the four living creatures and the elders, a lamb that seemed to have been slain. He had seven horns and seven eyes. These are the seven spirits of God sent out into the world. He came and received the scroll from the right hand of the one who sat on the throne. When he took it, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb. Each of the elders held a harp and gold bowls filled with incense, which are the prayers of the holy ones. They sang a new hymn. "Worthy are you to receive the scroll and break open its seals, for you were slain, and with your blood you purchased for God those from every tribe and tongue, people and nation. You made them a kingdom and priests for our God, and they will reign on earth." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God.
The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God.
Sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King.
The Lamb has made us a kingdom of priests to serve our God.
Let them praise his name in the festive dance. Let them sing praise to him with timbrel and harp. Harp, for the Lord loves his people, and he adorns the lowly with victory.
The Lord is the King of Christ.
Let the faithful exalt in the Lord. Let them sing for joy upon their couch.
from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus drew near Jerusalem, he saw the city and wept over it, saying, "If this day you only knew what makes for peace, but now it is hidden from your eyes. For the days are coming upon you when your enemies will raise a palisade against you. They will encircle you and hem you in on all sides. They will smash you to the ground and your children within you. And they will not leave one stone upon another within you, because you did not recognize the time of your visitation." The Gospel of the Lord.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. We recognize those words because we hear it each day in the Holy Eucharist, the invitation to come and receive our Lord present to us in his body and blood in the Holy Eucharist. This great gift. But notice, it's not simply an invitation to receive Jesus, our crucified and risen Lord. It also proclaims his great victory, the one who takes away the sins of the world. Beautifully, and perhaps because of the freestanding altar, you haven't been able to see it, but we have on a high altar in front of the tabernacle, below the mensa, a beautiful carving of the Lamb of God. And in fact, it's what we hear today proclaimed in the book of Revelation. The Lamb who was slain, who is worthy to open up the scroll, sealed with seven seals. Those seven seals make it clear that this scroll is not any scroll, but has a message of great importance. Notice in our readings today, both the first reading from the book of Revelation and the Gospel, there is weeping. Weeping in the book of Revelation because it appears no one is worthy to open up the scroll, to reveal what God is doing to bring salvation. But there is one. Who is the one worthy to open the scroll, to bring about God's work of salvation? It is the Lamb. The Lamb was slain and rose on the third day. That's not simply a title, but an expression of God bringing about his great work to bring humanity back to himself. The Lord himself weeps because the people of Jerusalem have two deficits. One, they fail to recognize this great work that God is accomplishing through Jesus himself. And they also, because of their stubbornness of heart, not cooperating with God's will, are bringing about the eventual destruction of the holy city that would occur in 70 AD by the Romans. We can quickly pass over that destruction since it happened 2,000 years ago. But we understand Jesus' grief, lamenting not only of their closed-heartedness, but the suffering they would endure. Imagine with the Romans coming to encircle the city and bring about a siege, how the suffering would be so great as people would die of starvation with no food source. And then, once the walls were breached, the great destruction, as we hear, not one stone would be laid upon another. The destruction the Romans brought to Jerusalem. And Jesus is not angry that the people aren't receiving him. He's moved to great compassion. He weeps for them that both in their temporal lives and their spiritual lives, they are closed. What does that mean for us today in 2020? Do we see the opportunities for God to be breaking into our lives in even greater fashion? We're so very sensitive and aware of what we're going through right now, continuing to be burdened by COVID-19, by the divisiveness in our nation, by so many things that seem to be weighing upon us. And yet, do we see God designed to break into our lives in a fuller fashion? Or are we so focused on that which we suffer, we can't see how God is accompanying us in the midst of this? Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. And we understand the invitation to be so much broader, not simply taking away offense, broken commandments, but as we hear that Jesus takes away the sins of the world, the reason why God laments that we are sinners and continue to choose sin is that sin always brings unhappiness and suffering. As we proclaim the Lamb slain for us, he takes away not only sin, but the sadness, lack of joy, and suffering that sin brings. The Lord is victorious, and we share his victory by living our baptism fully and by being strengthened by the Lord who comes to feed us in his body and his blood. Grateful to God that we share in Christ's victory over sin and death, we turn now to intercede on behalf of the church and the whole world.
Let all members of the church may be given the gifts of the Holy Spirit to help us in our witness to the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That policy makers may find their help in the Lord and be strengthened for their work by his grace. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That those who undergo persecution may find consolation in the sufferings of the Lamb. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That our faith community may grow in compassion of Jesus and their love of neighbor for one another. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us also pray for those who work outside, exposed to the elements, that they may be protected and kept warm and safe. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That the faithful departed may soon be admitted to the Lamb's high banquet. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Now in silence, please take a moment and offer up your own petitions. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those from Puerto Rico, both living on the island and those dispersed, who today celebrate Our Lady of Divine Providence, that through Mary's intercession, they will continue to grow as the holy people of God with Puerto Rican roots. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, you have blessed us with the gift of this new day, the opportunity to live in closer friendship with you and in service to one another. brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up your mouth to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
And give us our name.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. In the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. our sins, but of the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. To be near God is my happiness, to place my hope in God the Lord.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Amen.
the body of Christ.
Amen.
We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery. Humbly implore you, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
That is the Spirit of God. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. We are our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke you.